What's going on, everybody? How's your day going? Today we're gonna work on bushings. I'm already halfway through this process. I just want this to be an informational video to share with you guys. So we're working on the O2 bug eye today. This should go for multiple generations of WRX and STI and probably other models of Subaru. But for the trailing arm, what you gotta do is unbolt the three bolts from up here, and then you unbolt this rear, and then this is where your bushing's at. I've already pushed it out. I gotta clean up some rust in there. But you use a puller. Use this guy here. I don't exactly remember the name of it, but it's a three prong. I think it's a bolt or pulley extractor. But yeah, what I did is I took the bushing and I cut around it so that these could fit on there, clamped it on, and then just proceeded to twist this in, and it popped out with ease, which is a lot quicker than pulling your whole car apart and putting it in a press, because you know that's a lot more time and effort. So this is a quick and easy method. Quick, dirty, easy method. But this is what the bushings look like on my car. So as you can see, when it was on the car, I cut there, just cut a couple spots so I could get those fingers on there. And then we pushed from this side and then pushed it through. And that was super easy. Got the white line here, the aftermarket. These are the split apart bushings. So you push one into each side. So this is what they look like, and then there's a metal rod inside that goes in for the bolt. But yeah, that's what we're doing today. All right, quick intermission in this video. Work on my brother's STI. He has a Cobb short throw shifter, but they're weird because instead of producing the right part, they make you put tape on it when you get it, which is kind of dumb. But we're doing that, fixing that, and then his, forgot what they're called. What are these guys? His bushing, stay bushing, is broken from when he tried to do this originally. So we're fixing that, and we're hoping that helps with how loose everything is. I forgot to record this, but I finished up my brother's car. We just pulled the old stay bushing out and then lubed up a new one and shoved it back in. So it was pretty easy, but we're gonna get back to this guy here. We are, oh, where's my flashlight? That is an extension. There we go. All right. So I already got her back on, but I already squeezed these guys on, as you'll see in those clips. I put them on. So I didn't do this the exact way you should, but you should wire brush it. Like if you have a drill, you should put a wire brush on there and brush it. So I didn't get all the rust. I got most of it, but I will be replacing these hubs with STI ones soon. But when you go to put it back on, you want to install these bolts, try to line up where the previous marks were and get that tight. And then I secured the bolt in here, which I would actually suggest getting the bolt in this side first and then lining up the rest of the trailing arm. And then per instructions from the Subaru manual, tighten these bolts, and then you need to put all the pressure onto this guy before you tighten that up. So what I did is I jacked it up high enough and I slid this guy underneath, jacked that up, and then kind of replicated kind of where it would sit, and then I tightened it up. So the front believe is 72 foot-pounds and back here is 66 foot-pounds. So that's the whole video. It's pretty simple if you do it this way, instead of replacing the whole knuckle or hub. So, but that's it. So peace.